Welcome to the Cybersecurity Speaker Series, presented by NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. Our mission is to augment and amplify NSA's ability to prevent and eradicate threats to national security systems and the defense industrial base by establishing open, robust, and collaborative relationships across industry and government. Through bidirectional threat intelligence sharing and joint analytic tradecraft development, these partnerships leverage unique talents and capabilities to enhance cybersecurity across the nation. In this series, you'll hear about the work we do here and its real-world applications, bringing these insights to you through some of the top minds at NSA.
Welcome to the Speaker Series from NSA's Cybersecurity Collaboration Center. My name is Josiah Dykstra, and I'm a technical fellow here at NSA. The Collaboration Center is our intersection of outreach and collaboration between government and industry in cybersecurity. In this Speaker Series, we invite NSA experts to come share their insights and contributions to this field. Our topic for today is machine learning for malware classification, and my guest is Dr. Jennifer McGreevy. Jennifer, welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Jennifer, I think a lot of people have heard this two-word phrase, machine learning, before, but it probably means something different to everybody who has heard it. Start by telling us, what is machine learning and how does it apply in cybersecurity?
Sure. So machine learning is a subset of data science that involves learning from big data to create a model that can very quickly be used to make new predictions. And a simple example is when a streaming service provides recommendations on movies someone may enjoy watching. Streaming services have an enormous amount of data about subscribers' past choices. So they may know that people who watch movie A also watch movie B, or that people in a certain age range watch movies from a particular decade. And so the machine learning algorithm can learn from all of this past data and very quickly create a model that can very quickly make predictions on new movies you may enjoy watching. NSA doesn't care about movie predictions, but we do care about malware. Our objective is to predict whether files are malicious or benign, and if malicious, to try to use machine learning to predict the malware family, and to also provide an explanation as to why the predictions are made.
Thanks. I think of machine learning a little bit like a really rudimentary human brain. We learn from inputs we see, and it allows us to make predictions. You talked about that for movies. What are the inputs and outputs for malware classification?
So what gets fed into the machine learning algorithm are features. And the features are derived or extracted right from the data. And so, for example, for a movie, the features might be topic categories, such as action, drama, the date the movie was released, and so on. For malware, the features could be bytes extracted from the executable, metadata about the file, or even data that's derived from running the executable. For a mobile app on your phone, for example, the features could be permissions that the app makes from your phone. And suspicious features could be permission to access your contact list or permission to send a text message from your phone. What comes out at the end, the machine learning takes all of this feature data, learns from it, creates a model, and what comes out at the end is a trained classifier, or what we call a trained model, that can make predictions on new data.
Thank you. That's a helpful explanation. It is clear that NSA cares about malware. In our cybersecurity mission, knowing if a file is safe or benign or malicious is an important distinction. Talk about how machine learning is helping NSA.
Our primary goal is to assist the malware analyst. And machine learning can provide results that can corroborate results from other automated tools and capabilities to ensure more accurate reporting and to possibly detect new malware that's never been seen before when traditional signature detection fails. Machine learning can also expedite an analyst's work by narrowing the scope of analysis to a smaller set of malware families. Machine learning can also provide top features that led to the prediction. And the malware analyst could use those features and pivot on them to find similar malware in our data repository that's already been analyzed. And then finally, machine learning can help handle the increasing volume of data by providing an ability to bin and prioritize the data quickly.
I really appreciate that machine learning can help humans. That has a special place for me, and I'm glad that it is contributing to that as well. So antivirus companies, I think, understand that machine learning is powerful, and they have in the past sort of focused on signature-based detection. Talk about the difference between signature-based malware detection and machine learning-based.
Antivirus software commonly detects maliciousness by matching signatures of already reported known malware. And these signatures could be snippets of code in the executable or behavior-based rules that capture the behavior on the network as the malware runs. And these signatures tend to be unique and attributable. The malware authors have caught on to this, and so they will continually change the code to evade signature detection. And so it becomes a cat and mouse game where signatures have to constantly be updated or newly created as the malware is changed to evade detection. And this is why malware can be missed by AV products and go undetected on a system. The good news is that, as the saying goes, malware can hide, but it has to run. And so a malware author can change the code to try to evade detection, but it still has to retain its essential functionality. And the machine learning can capture this essential functionality, learn from it, learn from non-attributable features, and potentially detect malware when traditional signature detection fails.
I'll say, when I go to tech expos and conferences and see vendors advertising, machine learning is a pretty prominent component that is advertised by at least marketing departments, if not technical capabilities. Since industry is going down this route of adopting machine learning, what is the role here for government?
So AV products do have machine learning in their products, but what's missing are the features that lead to the predictions. And so machine learning tends to be black boxes in the AV products that contribute but don't solely lead to alerts. And so the features aren't usually made available to the users and therefore can't be used for analysis of files. What's also missing for government use is our secret sauce, which is our classified data to train on.
That makes a lot of sense. There's clearly a role for both to contribute in a complementary way, I think. Talk to me a little bit about performance. How does industry or government, for that matter, know if the machine learning is performing accurately?
We measure the quality of our classifiers by computing two metrics, precision and recall. Recall is the proportion of all of the malware that is predicted to be malware, or the detection rate. That metric alone means nothing. If I were to tell you our trained machine learning model could detect maliciousness on every single malware file in a data set, you might jump to the very wrong conclusion that our classifier was fantastic. Mm. But what if our classifier also detected malicious or predicted malicious on every benign file in that data set? So we have to compute another metric called precision, which is the proportion of total correct predictions. And so if you have a great recall rate and you have a great precision rate, or small false positive rate, or small number of benign files that are predicted as malware, then those two metrics together can enable us to determine whether a classifier is good.
I think that helps a lot. And having those metrics gives us a little bit of confidence about how well it's working. There's still this general question among users about trust. Can we trust machine learning? What are your thoughts about that?
So just as AV products are not 100% successful, machine learning also has an error rate, even if it's small. The goal is not to solely use machine learning to detect and classify malware, but to use it in conjunction with other automated capabilities. Most machine learning capabilities can provide probabilities that go along with predictions. So in our case, these are probabilities of maliciousness. A probability of 1 would indicate a certain malware, a probability of 0 would indicate certain benignware, and a probability of 0.5 would indicate that the classifier can't make a prediction. And good classifiers would have
mostly probabilities that fall close to 0 and 1 with few in the middle. And what we do is we call predictions that have probabilities close to 0.5 uncertain. And this isn't a limitation of the machine learning capability, but just an indication that the file may need further in-depth analysis or there needs to be other automated tools. It's okay to occasionally give an uncertain prediction. We just want to minimize the number of wrong predictions. So providing probabilities that go along with the predictions can help the analysts interpret the results and give them more trust in the results. Also providing features, as I mentioned earlier, that led to the prediction can help the analysts understand why the prediction is made.
Sure, what about the use of multiple algorithms, the different views of the same problem?
Yes. Having multiple different machine learning capabilities that are based on different feature sets can definitely increase confidence in the results when the majority of them agree on the prediction. And then finally, it's important to provide metrics like precision and recall on how well the classifier does overall.
I think those things make this a really exciting area. The fact that machine learning has been going on a long time, but there's still room for advancement and evolution must be really exciting. Maybe you can tell us about a couple of challenges that remain open in this kind of work.
Yes. So there are several challenges. The biggest challenge with all machine learning is having enough data to train on and having the right data to train on. For us, it's just as important to have a good benign set as it is to have a good malware set. Having good labeled data for what we call supervised learning is also a challenge. If we want to classify malware by families, for example, we need to know what constitutes a family. So a malware author might change code by swapping out an encryption scheme, but leave everything else the same. And we might call that a new version. But if the malware author changes code to that changes the functionality of the malware, then we may need to have a new family name. The computational cost of doing machine learning is also a challenge. If you're training over a very large data set, it can be very computationally expensive. And the feature extraction and derivation can be expensive too, depending on what it is. For us, if we disassemble the file or we actually have to run the malware, that those things are very computationally expensive. And then also obfuscated, packed, and encrypted malware is also a challenge. We often have to run decryption and unpacking tools first before running our machine learning capabilities. And then finally, machine learning is only as good as the data it learns from. So the capabilities have to be retrained frequently to keep pace with the evolving malware.
Well, Jennifer, thank you for explaining this to us. Thank you for this work in the field, and thank you for being here.
Thank you.
Please stay tuned to NSA's Twitter account @NSA Cyber for the announcement of future talks. See you next time.